Hundreds of teenage runaways head for London every year, some as young as 12. Half those seeking refuge at Centrepoint's emergency shelters in the West End are under 18. Many have left home or been thrown out after family rows. Others have nowhere to go after a lifetime in care. They come from all over Britain. 1,000 of the runaways taken in by this refuge each year are from outside the capital. Youngsters like these, who ran away from trouble at home but found no help in their hometowns, so they joined the 3,000 who sleep on London streets each night.
Why did I leave Scotland? Family breakdown, family troubles, things like that.
What brought me? What in Hamilton, any hostels? The nearest ones to Hamilton is Glasgow. And try to get in a hostel in Glasgow, can't get in though, because they're all full up now.
Many of the young people, they still believe this myth that London is paved with gold. And the trouble for us is not that they turn up, it's that they turn up unprepared. They don't have any money with them, they haven't arranged accommodation, they haven't tried to sort out a job before they come. So if the government can put money into groups in their home areas that gives out this kind of advice before they come, that would be very important for us in our work.
And today the government answered those demands, pledging £3 million for schemes outside London to stop runaways flocking to the capital.
This £3 million is to help fund voluntary projects offering advice and assistance to young homeless, to help them get started, perhaps offer emergency beds, put them in touch with their local supports so they can stay in their own community, find somewhere to live and find a job.
Charities for the homeless say the amount of government grant is disappointing, but it's an important first step towards keeping youngsters off London's streets. Kerry Swain, Thames News.